Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a collab with some of the other moms on YouTube Mommy Meetup, and I am so excited for this one. I have my mommy fuel. This cup is huge, you guys. I got it at Target. It's almost as big as my head, and it contains my entire French press worth of coffee in here. And on that note, we're going to be talking about me time today. Thanks to Jessica for coming up with this idea for this collab. I will link her channel and all the other ladies participating in this collab in a playlist below so you can go and check out all of their videos today. We're all going to be talking to you about me time and how we do me time, because as moms, not even just as moms, but just as human beings, we all need some me time. And that can mean different things to different people. In the last like 6 months, I've taken a little bit more care to try to get more me time. And whether it's quantity more me time or just a few times of quality me time, honestly, I take what I can get. Now, I am a night owl. I am not one of these moms who gets up before the kids and has coffee and reads the Bible before the kids get up. I can't do it. I don't like saying the word can't, but y'all, I can't do it. I just can't. I wish I could. I wish so much that I could do that, but I can't. Instead, I would rather be up very late after everyone has gone to bed. I think I appreciate it more after a long day of it kicking back and doing whatever I want to do on my time. And so one of those things is any sort of crafting. You know I love my sewing. You know, maybe you know, I don't know if you're new here, but I love sewing. I sew most of my own clothes. I've gotten really into planning and journaling lately, which is a great de-stressor. When we moved into our house 7 years ago, we got a garden tub up here in our master bathroom. There's no jets or anything. I didn't want to have to deal with that, but it is a really large tub, and it's perfect for baths. And so that's something that I don't make enough time for. And I think it was the year after Brayden was born. I asked for some Lush bath bombs for Christmas. And I told my husband, if you're going to spend that kind of money, I promise I'm going to use these. It was my New Year's resolution to take one bath a week. Well, that fizzled out really quickly. I started aiming for one bath a month. And I've been pretty good at keeping up with that, especially in the winter months when sometimes all I want to do is just sit in something warm. And it makes the whole room warm when you run that hot water in the tub. And I've used Lush bath bombs. My sister sent me some bath bombs that she got in her city. There's a local artisan who makes them, and she sent them to me for the last two Christmases, and they're amazing, and the ingredients are really good. They're handmade and they're fantastic. So that's basically what I'm going to talk about today. And I'm talking about this today as kind of more accountability for myself. I'm one of those people, I relax sometimes by getting busy with other things, which is fine. There's really no wrong way to de-stress unless you are hurting yourself or someone else, really. And my kids are small and they require a lot of attention from me. And it can get really overwhelming at times. I only have two kids and they're 6 and 4. It's not like they're babies. And so I can very easily go into my sewing room and sew. I could very easily get busy with YouTube. But you know what? Sometimes I need to sit and do nothing. And that is what I am shooting for here. I want to take some more baths. I want to relax, physically, mentally relax. I want to kind of have a little accountability here. And also I want to share a recipe for DIY bath salts. So I'm also going to be sharing that with you today. I really do love my bath time. I set it up. You'll see it here in a second, but I set it up and I've got barely any lights on. I don't like candles. I don't know. I don't want this to be too much work. The stressing, like, I don't want to stress over something that's supposed to reduce my stress, if that makes sense. But I like to put whatever, like bath fizzy or bath salts or whatever I've got going on. And in this video, I'm going to show you a DIY bath salts that I have used. I think this would be my third time to use it. And my kids and husband are out. So, yeah, I'm going to take a bath. I don't care that it's 11:24 a.m. I don't care. I'm going to take a bath. And you know what? I am probably going to be better off, and it's a Saturday, I'm probably going to be better off the rest of the day because I took this time to do nothing. So let's go ahead and jump right into my DIY bath salts recipe. I like to run my baths pretty hot. This one I ran not so hot just because last time it was way too hot. But I let this warm up, and during this time is when I mix up my bath salts. And for this, I'm using a glass batter bowl and a metal spoon. And the first ingredient you want is some sort of unscented body wash. And I love this Everyone soap. I use it for the boys. I use it for myself. It's just really good. And I'm also using Plant Therapy's Tranquil Synergy Blend because I really like the way that this smells. This is not kid friendly, so don't use it with your littles. And also some just plain Epsom salts. And I don't measure anything really, so I'm dumping, the recipe calls for about 2 tablespoons of the body wash and then 5 drops of the Tranquil oil, and mix those up together first because the body wash will dilute the essential oil enough. And I'm using 5 drops here. And Tranquil is one of Plant Therapy's Synergy blends. And if you want to try it out, be sure to use my affiliate link. It is in the description box below. And here you can see the color of the body wash is changing because of the essential oil in there. I'm trying to get it nice and combined first. And then you're supposed to add 1/2 cup of Epsom salts. I, again, don't measure. I kind of eyeball it. I prefer a little bit more Epsom salt. That's just what I like. And so I'm just kind of dumping it in here and mixing it up. You want to mix it up until it's at a nice gloppy consistency. I know that's really scientific, but you want to make sure that everything is combined as much as possible. And at that point, you want to pour it into your warm bath water. The warm slash hot bath water will help to dissolve the salt faster. And I just like to kind of dump it in there across the length of the tub, and to get every little bit out of the bowl, run it through the water and kind of distribute it that way. Now it's time to set the mood, so I'm turning off the lights and picking up my Kindle for some Netflix. I decided this day, after going through the menu for quite some time, I finally decided on one of my favorite shows ever that I can relax to, which is The Office. And so I turned that on, and I was gonna say, can you guess this episode? But no, it just said at the top, Company Picnic. And so now I am all ready for my bath, and I just get ready to go and hop right in. Thank you so much for watching today. Please be sure to give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if it's your first time here. And don't forget to check out all the other ladies doing videos about their me time habits today. I hope you're having a great day. See you next time. Bye.